Hello, Africa. A very good evening to you. It is Saturday, and of course, every Saturday, you know what happens in the world, on the African continent, and of course, in Ghana, in the capital, Accra. My name is Harriet Nate, and you are welcome to the only show that brings you happenings from the diplomatic community or within the diplomatic space. And this is Diplomatic Affairs. So today we are going to be talking about cultural diplomacy and, of course, Colombia. Now, cultural diplomacy is a type of public diplomacy and soft power that includes the power that gives you what you want when it comes to how you want things to be done and the results that you are looking for. And so today is all about cultural diplomacy. So I'm taking you to Colombia, and we'll look at how Colombia has adopted one of the approaches of diplomacy to get results, especially right here in Ghana. We'll talk about fostering relations between Ghana and Colombia, and also looking at the many business and investment opportunities that the two countries can build together and develop at the same time. So we'll talk about all of that. And so my guest today is the Colombian ambassador to Ghana, Her Excellency Ambassador Claudia Tubar Quintero. I hope I got the name right. And it's all going to be about Colombia. I'll talk about the routes in Colombia. We'll talk about bilateral relations between Ghana and Colombia. We'll also talk about the people of Colombia, the culture. What is it that we have in common as two nations? So that is what we will be talking about, my business for today. So make a date with us as always. We are right here, and it's all about diplomatic affairs. So stay tuned and be my guest. I'll see you after this break.
Even if it makes me blind, I just want to see the light. Breathe in, leave it all behind. I just want to see the light.
Hello, what are you doing Tuesday to Friday, 7:30 to 9 o'clock p.m. every day? You should be watching The Couch. I'll tell you why. On Tuesdays, we talk social issues, lifestyle, health, all those everyday issues that affect us in the big ways. Let's Wednesdays are for book reviews. Thursdays are for the hard talk, those socio-economic, policy-oriented, political questions that demand for the tough questions to be asked. Our personality profiling Fridays, when we get to know the stories behind the winning personalities we love. Inspirational story from inspirational personalities. Hey, listen, you really cannot miss The Couch with me, Amma, but still, the only TV show with a heart.
Really on the inside. All your
Welcome back. It is a beautiful weather right here in Accra. Well, from where we are transmitting from, I hope that it rained at your end as well, or your side as well. Well, you come. Welcome back. We are still live from the studios of Pan-African Television. The show is Diplomatic Affairs. Like I said, this is the only show that brings you happenings from the diplomatic community. If it did happen and it pertains to diplomacy, trust me, right here, we will bring the right people, the resource persons to come and help us understand the issues. So today is a very special day for me because I've been looking forward to this interview for a very long time. And here we are making it happen. So I'm excited about it. But before we go to the agenda of the day or the business of day, I would want to take one story that is very important. Now, do you know anything about the Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana? Have you heard about them in any way? Well, if you haven't, I'm just going to share a story with you. Recently, they embarked on a tree planting project in Accra as part of building publicity and, of course, making their presence felt in the country and getting to know the operations and who they are, what they represent. They embarked on a tree planting project, and we were there to give them coverage. So let me share the story with you. When we come back from that story, then we will begin our business for today.
The Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana is cautioning the general public on the need to tackle environmental issues as personal problems and also avoid illegal mining and other environmental activities that contribute to climate change, which has become a threat to the existence of humans and other living things. Addressing the media, the Honorary Consul of Belgium to Ghana, who also serves as the Dean of the Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana, Dimitri Avram, reiterated the need to create awareness on climate change and take action. The Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana, as part of their social responsibility, embarked on a Green Ghana initiative with over 200 seedlings planted along the Legon-Madina Highway in Accra with the objective to beautify the city and create awareness on climate change. Council Dimitri Avram said the initiative forms part of the president's agenda to making Accra the cleanest city in Africa.
It is important that we protect our environment, and certainly the event today is to contribute in more green and to educate the population that it is important that we preserve our forests. We are part of associate to the foundation of Prince Albert II of Monaco that has one of their main aims, protection of environment. And certainly forests are very important to our life.
He said, Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana is involved in several other initiatives with the country contributing to the socio-economic growth of those they represent, the host country, and also fostering relations between them. The Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana was founded in 1994. It represents five continents, which is Europe, America, Asia, Africa, and Oceania, with over 40 members.
All right, so that was the Honorary Consular Corps of Ghana. Of course, they embarked on a tree planting project here in the capital, Accra, and we were invited to go and cover that program. So we are looking forward to hosting them on the show today. So not today, but I mean sometime very soon. Today is all about Colombia, and we are talking about cultural diplomacy, and we are talking about the routes in Colombia. You will get to know the real story on the ground. Of course, this is just to get the right information to you, because I know you have been reading bits and pieces, you know, from almost all the platforms, the international platforms. So it is appropriate that we have someone in the studio to help us understand the real issues on the ground when it comes to the routes in Colombia, and also talk about the bilateral relations that exist between Ghana and Colombia, the people, the culture. My guest is Her Excellency Ambassador Claudia Tubar Quintero. Well, I hope I got the name right. Did I get the name right, Claudia?
Fantastic. You are doing fine. Every time better.
Well, thank you very much. And she also serves as the Dean of the Diplomatic Corps. So we will talk a bit about that as well. At the end of the interview, you will get to know what an amazing person, I mean, she is. And she's a fine diplomat, and she's very passionate when it comes to women issues and, of course, youth empowerment. So we'll be talking all about that on the studio. Claudia, welcome to Diplomatic Affairs.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm really happy to be here in this Pan-African
television
studio.
Yes. And thank you so much.
That's why to make me happy, really.
We are very happy to have you too. Now, you look very beautiful in your outfit. Is that Ghanaian?
You know, today, before coming here, I was accompanying the commemoration of the Rwanda genocide. So it was 27 years ago. So that's why the ambassador told me, you can come black or purple. And I decided that this is purple. And I hope that you see it purple, because when I saw everybody in black, I said, well, anyhow, I went there and accompanied her in a very special day of commemoration. And then I came to this wonderful studio. I had to leave before to meet you.
Well, lucky us, right? You know, the Rwandan High Commissioner to Ghana is a friend of ours. So I'm happy that, you know, she asked you to come, even though your presence was very much needed at the event.
She allowed me. Look, I am happy for many reasons, if you allow me to tell you. And it is something that I have together with you, and it's the Pan-African spirit. I am a diaspora ambassador, and I am a Pan-African person. I am from a country that has one of the largest Afro-descendant populations of the Americas, and it is Colombia. In the Americas, there are three countries that have the biggest and largest population. They are the United States, Brazil, and Colombia. So we are the third one. And we have a population like 15% of our population is Afro-descendant. We have 50 million inhabitants. So as ambassador in Ghana, one of my purposes, absolutely very clear, is to link the diaspora, the Colombian diaspora, with the continent, with the mother African continent, for humanity. Because it's not only for them. I always say all humanity
all
came from Africa. So I am celebrating today also that with you. Thank you so much, because this comes from the heart.
Oh, this means a lot to me. Thank you very much. I know you are a Pan-Africanist, because I have seen your works on the ground. I have seen how passionate you are when it comes to bringing our country and yours together. It's all about unity. It's all about looking for the many opportunities that exist for all of us to tap into it and grow together. And so I am not surprised at all to know that you actually render solidarity to the Rwandan High Commissioner. And of course, I know she's a very good friend. You are friends with almost all the diplomats in the country, not only because you are the head, but again, because you have a very good heart, and all you want is let's come together and grow it and share together. And that's the spirit I love about you. That's what I love about you when it comes to your job as a diplomat representing the good people of Colombia in Ghana.
You know, Colombia is a country that shares knowledge and shares the spirit. And we find that with the African people, it is very pleasant. It means to have relationship of friendship, of mutual interest, and of advancing together. I say that is a cooperation is that, is making links so that we can work together, exchanging the knowledge and the information. And not always, the other thing that I have learned here is that you don't have to always do such monumental things. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Because there are countries that can come and invest and create infrastructure and give buses and things, and Colombia cannot do that. So we do something that I enjoy a lot, and it is the human contact, and it is the exchange of good practices. We have a lot of different cooperation in different areas. So, for example, for gender, for health, in education, in agriculture, in public good practices, in teaching the communities also, for example, how to build up, how to change their hygienic habits. Mm-hmm. We have done that. Mm-hmm. Or how to use alternative light. Mm-hmm. We have so many experiences of that way, but these experiences goes directly to the people.
Yeah, the people.
To the people. And that's what I love. And
right.
To the communities. Mm-hmm. And so, In that way, we have been able to do a lot, and to also bring people from Colombia to meet their counterparts. And in some occasions, we have been able to take people from Ghana
to Colombia.
So, for example, in art, I know you love art and gastronomy.
We will come to that. Don't take the best out of my mouth. Don't worry, we will come to that. But, well, once again, thank you very much for coming. Now, let's talk about, I want to get to know Colombia. We want to get to know the people of Colombia. We want to get to know the leadership of Colombia. Now, let's talk about the protests happening in Colombia.
Now, I think,
yes.
Today.
I mean, let's talk about it. It's been 3 weeks.
What is happening
in Colombia?
I will tell you. Colombia is a democratic country that lives accordingly to rule of law, that respects human rights, and that is an open country. In geographically, it's open. We have the oceans and the jungles and the so large frontiers, borders with all our neighbors. So we, in a way, are open in our spirit and welcome the people. So all the countries of the world, including Colombia, have been affected economically in extremely because of the COVID. And for Colombia, it has been a very bad time, because we have had a high range of infections. People, we have had 83,000 deaths.
83,000 deaths from
so
COVID-19.
This is a disease of COVID-19. We have had 3.5 million of people infected, and we have had 2 million and something recovered, and all the special units, care units, mm-hmm. Are completely occupied, engaged. So,
what is the population of Colombia?
51 million inhabitants.
51 million?
Yes. See, we are a large country, and so this is the first situation. The second situation is that we had lockdowns for two different periods for long. We began from April, mm-hmm. like to December. It was a complete lockdown. So it was a deceleration of the economy, and the production went down, mm-hmm. and it happens in everywhere in the world. It is not only a Colombian situation, but there are other situations that are not only Colombian. So people got tired. People are like tired of the situation, and they are feeling that the country is not fulfilling their needs to feed themselves, to work themselves, to get the job. So this is the feeling of some group of people. At the same time, we have situations of migration mm-hmm. into Colombia. With the Venezuelan people, that we have 1,800,000 people living in Colombia that came, and the country had to receive them.
Migrating illegally from Venezuela
into Colombia. So that we have. And we had also a conflict that comes from the previous peace agreement and the dissidences of the guerrillas that didn't accept that peace agreement, the people that the drug traffickers, mm-hmm. that also, so all of these people that I'm mentioning are discontent. The president is a young president with commitment, fully committed with the people, with the country, with a good heart, with a good a team in general terms, and he presented the problem that was seen. The problem comes before, and I will explain to you, but that the problem came, was seen by the most of the people when he presented before the Congress a tax reform. So
that was the cause of the problem.
That was the not for me. I am going to tell you exactly, not only for me, but yes, it was the trigger.
Okay, that was the trigger.
Yes, not necessarily the cause. The cause is different.
But that triggered protests in the country.
Yes, absolutely, yes, that's the trigger. So people said, how comes that we, being poor as we are, in the parliament they didn't accept it. They had opposition, but however, it was being studied, and the people riot because the opposition, mm-hmm. There is a left party mm-hmm. Leader that was an ex-guerrilla man. The one that we have talked, he belonged to the guerrilla, and he has called the people to riot, to protest, because that tax means the people that are suffering, the poor people, will be perhaps having to pay some. That was the saying, to pay duties. And what happened is that the explanation of how the reform was being proposed was never communicated fully to the people. They didn't understand what was it. So at the same time, the president was, and it was public, going to buy some planes in Colombia, for the army, or for the. So they said, how come that they are going to ask for the tax to increase the budget, mm-hmm. to buy the planes. Mm-hmm. So that was another discussion that was not truth. It was the money that was being asked for was to be able to keep helping from this time to December coming year to the people of victims of the COVID. The president, 4 days after the first riot, he retired. He decided to retire from the parliament, that proposal. And he realized that what was happening really is that he didn't discuss it before.
That was a big problem.
That was a huge problem.
It's like taking the people for granted. You are making policies for the people. Sometimes it goes
and
to...
And it was a mistake that he recognized.
It goes to parliament for them to look at it, to discuss and see if it is good. It's going to be a good policy.
Absolutely.
Before implementing it. But out of nowhere, he decided to, you know,
to some few
bring this issue up, and then without discussing it or without even getting the people to know what is happening. I mean, this couldn't have been possible. You know, you could not implement a policy that is meant to look out for the people or to take care of a situation without first of all even engaging the people.
Yes.
So that was a huge mistake on the part of the Colombian government. Right?
Yes, of course it was. But
you also mentioned that the opposition is spearheading the protest or the demonstration.
Yes, absolutely, yes. So I am going to go to the second part of this.
We will not have all the time because we have other interesting issues to also talk about, for instance.
But I want to tell you something before
please
to
do.
Close that because
please
I don't
do.
Want to
right.
leave in the
So hang in. So we'll finish it and then let me just...
No. So what happened is that we have been able to see that the riots are taking place for different reasons and with different liaisons. So the riots are taking place to destabilize the government, not to protest for one thing in particular. It is, and we have found out, that the word is an orchestrated plan. It is not a spontaneous happening. And it started happening not only in this time, but the president came into power the 2018.
Yeah.
2019, he have the first one. And in 2020, he has been having riots continuously, every time escalating up. So what we have found, and I was reading because I wanted to talk to you and be able to answer anything and give you my really real feeling was, for example, that they are mounting, orchestrating reactions from the different media, but in a way that it are not the real reaction, but no, that they are making and sending fake
stories
with pictures of previous situations to thousands and millions of people through the networking. So there are different places. This is like the troll accounts.
All right, I have a video that I would want us to show. If it is ready, please let's show that video. It came from the routes in Colombia, so. If the video is ready, can we show the video and just explain what it is, just to give our viewers a sense of what we are talking about on the show? Can we take a look at the video, please?
Mayo, Uri Popayán.
Bendito, estamos en Ecopetrol. Y si el ejército, el ESMA y la policía nos sigue atacando, pues lastimosamente volamos todo jumbo y huepú.
Okay, so that was just a video that we decided to show you, just so you have an idea of what is happening in Colombia for the past 3 weeks. Yes. And of course, we have the ambassador of Colombia to Ghana to speak on the issues that are happening in Colombia, and of course, to talk about other positive things as well. So now, Claudia, what is the way forward for the people of Colombia? Because we know there have been many, many people involved at this level. Now, you are saying the opposition is behind the protests in Colombia. But what is the way forward? Is there going to be a dialogue?
No, of course.
What is the way forward so we can move from this chapter to other things?
The president and the people that has different points of view want to protect the democracy, the country, the region, because we believe that the problem with Colombia is not only addressed to Colombia, it's addressed to the region. Mm-hmm. And so we are like a standard, mm-hmm. a very important country in order to balance the region, in order to defend democracy and rule of law. So that's what the president is doing: dialogue, changes in whatever he needs in the ministry,
yes,
and strengthening mm-hmm. in making the efforts that he has
restore calm.
With the legality, that with the rule of law, mm-hmm. and he's doing that, and many of us are accompanying him.
Okay, to achieve that at the end of the day. Well, I know that you will, as someone would say, this too shall pass. Don't worry, it's just a phase that Colombia is going through. So at the end of the day, we are hoping that peace will be restored very soon. Okay, so this is where we take a break. You're still watching Diplomatic Affairs. We've just started the conversation and we've been talking about the routes in Colombia. Like I said, we've been picking bits and pieces from the press, reading here and there. So now we've had the opportunity to host the Colombian ambassador to Ghana, and she is giving us an insight, telling us the happening, true happenings on the ground. So I believe that you may have picked a few things from her explanation. So we'll take a break. When we come back, there are so many interesting things that we want to talk about. The positives. Let's look at relations between Ghana and Colombia. We'll talk about the art exhibition, which I can't wait to show you. And so please stick and stay. We will be back after this break.
just wanna see the light. Breathe in, leave it all behind. I just wanna see the light. Even if it makes me blind, I just wanna see the light. Breathe in, leave it all behind. I just wanna see the light.
Welcome back. The show is still Diplomatic Affairs with me, Harriet Nate, and Ambassador Claudia Tumbai Quintero is my guest. The Colombian ambassador to Ghana is my guest as we discuss Colombia. We already talked about the rows in Colombia, of course, and we are about to talk about relations between Ghana and Colombia. Let's talk about bilateral relations between Ghana and Colombia. What is happening between these two countries?
Well, the first thing that I have to tell about this is that I am really privileged and happy to be the first ambassador ever of Colombia in Ghana for the bilateral relations. So I had the opportunity to open the embassy, mm-hmm. and it was not the time where the diplomatic relations started, mm. because first they started in the multilateral level at the UN, and there are agreements and this from 1988, mm. and I arrived in 2013. Mm.
So that was when the embassy was opened.
And so we opened it, and I opened it, mm-hmm. and at the same time, my country shows Ghana at the headquarters of our, at the base of our representation, mm-hmm. in the whole West African countries. So I am ambassador to Ghana and ambassador to the West African countries. And so this is an opportunity to really work and open up the relations, the diplomatic, and the expression of friendship, mm-hmm. and the interest to support and work together. So that's the message that we had. We work very much on different areas. Mm-hmm. So we try to promote cooperation, we try to promote, as I say, diaspora
engagements.
We work a lot in cultural activities. Mm-hmm. We work on business. We work on bringing together historians and or people, politicians. Mm-hmm. We have done many, many things in 8 years. Almost, mm. 7.5 years. And we have done so much, and we also had the slowing time in the coronavirus time. Mm-hmm. But we have gone, if you want, I tell you, for example, with health. Colombia.
The health sector.
Yes, health sector. We had, Colombia created a system that is called Kanguru Mother. Kanguru Mother.
Kanguru Mother.
Yeah, Kanguru Mothers are for neonatal children. Mm-hmm. So children that are born under 7 months of pregnancy, mm-hmm. of the mother. Mm-hmm. So this system was created in Colombia, and today is well known around the world, because it is, when it is born, the mother becomes one, mm. and the mother and the father.
Yeah.
I have to say that it's not only for the mother; for the two of them can act as the children, and they keep them touching their skin,
right.
and have to follow up on certain things, make some massage. There's a system, so we brought it. No, I didn't. I have to go back. There was two Colombian wonderful doctors, mm-hmm. that came here with that program of public
Colombian
health.
Doctors.
Yes, two Colombian doctors. And so they invited me, and I saw that, and what I did was to support MORD and bring MORD and take the Colombians to the Ghanaians to Colombia, and today Cofaridio Hospital is the very strong hospital in that program.
A friend of mine was there, and he spoke highly of that hospital.
The program. You know, you can imagine how this is for us. And the people there is committed with love, and they work. And so I still receive all the
feedback.
Yes, in everything, because they support. Because sometimes the mother feels sad, or sometimes the child is not very well, and so everybody is under that. So this is a program.
So that's the health sector.
Yes.
Which other areas are we cooperating?
Okay,
in?
I tried. Mm-hmm. I did try it, mm-hmm. and we couldn't arrive to the end because, again, for 3 years I brought scientists on malaria.
Okay.
That he was developing, he had a vaccine almost close, so we visited the president, we did everything. And it was him that at the last moment couldn't make it, but what I want to tell you is that this was a project that we really worked a lot, and there was a problem in the production of the vaccines, and so we had to delay. But that was something that we invested a lot of different efforts. So in malaria, we have an empowerment. We participate with NGOs.
Mm-hmm.
Like in different activities, so taking the psychologists and young girls to make with them, to teach them different things, but mostly to believe in themselves.
Okay.
And so we have to believe and make transformation through that belief. No, don't be afraid. Be confident.
Have confidence in yourself.
Have confidence in yourself. Believe in yourself, and you can do it. You can do it, no matter where you are.
Mm-hmm.
So this is for different. We do a lot of things like that, but it's like community
service.
Exactly. And we have gone to 11 different villages, for example, installing light, but not to villages that never before had light.
Electricity?
I had
right here in the country.
Right here.
Where exactly?
11.
Where exactly?
In different. Some
in the rural parts of the country.
That was to the one that I remember the most now, because the name is easier.
Mm-hmm.
It's Dodowa.
Oh, okay.
In Dodowa, right. They had, but it was to compensate their regions that they don't. In there are certain places that they don't have, didn't have light. But the other was to use, to help the people have to pay less.
Okay.
So that it could be done, and we went to 11 different villages, and we
11 of such villages.
Yes, it was fantastic, and we brought a special leader from Colombia. He has been growing too, and now he is a recognized leader internationally. And we have done the good practices in agriculture.
Okay.
I'm going to pass
right.
to agriculture. So, for example, we have done in one case is Ghana, who we want to receive from.
Okay.
Okay.
So Ghana is given.
No,
we
are exchanging this. Okay. We are working on plant how to treat the planting. The plantain and how to produce it and how to present it, how to, it's like a Greek business. First, it is how to cultivate properly, and secondly, how can you process it mm-hmm. to add value mm. to your crop. Then we have a cacao. Cacao is cocoa. Cocoa.
Yes, cocoa is cacao. Yeah, and that's Spanish. How you call it, cacao. In Spanish, all right.
Okay, so there is where we came, and Ghana has also helped the Colombian delegation in that, and we have changed it. Now we want to do it with Marañón also. Marañón is like a peanut.
Okay.
Okay, so that you have, we have done it with rice. Oh. We have given to you also practices, mm. right? So agriculture is something that we have.
So we are getting technical assistance from each other in these areas.
Exactly.
All right. Now, I know you are very passionate. So you just mentioned the health sector, which you are cooperating with,
yes.
you know, doing things with Ghana. You are doing so much in the health sector and then agriculture as well, which seems to be one of the biggest areas that you are exchanging ideas with when it comes to your relations with Ghana.
Artistic residential exchange.
Okay.
We have.
Artistic residential exchange. What is that?
It means, for example, we had the Ghanaian dancers mm-hmm. went to Colombia mm. and met some fantastic choreographers and they were giving classes and they were learning the Colombian rhythms, and at the end mm-hmm. They did it and they love it, and I invited them mm-hmm. on my national days mm. to make a performance, and it was beautiful.
That's cultural exchange.
And also we brought children mm-hmm. from the Pacific mm-hmm. region of Colombia mm. and they came with their orchestra. When we arrived to the university in Cape Coast, I think that it was, they were touching and playing marimba. Mm. And marimba is the xylophone. So they were...
With a xylophone?
Yes, xylophone, but they didn't call it xylophone.
Okay.
And it was not built exactly in the same way, but it was exactly the same mm. kind of instrument mm-hmm. and the same kind of sound. Mm. So with that, the first time I saw like a happening in the artistic exchange of recognizing Africa in Colombia.
Mm.
So the xylophone is a proof of the presence, the xylophone, the marimba. Mm. In Colombia it's called marimba. Okay. Now we have had
a few exchanges in different areas.
Yes,
now let's
sports
as well, right? Yes, I know you are big on sports.
We took all
some delegation from Ghana,
the Paralympic mm-hmm. And non-Paralympic athletes of Ghana went to Colombia to train in alto rendimiento. It's because of the they were preparing for the Olympics.
Okay.
And so they went for 1 month mm-hmm. and they became really prepared.
I see.
In a high performance.
High performance.
Performance center is the name. Yes.
I have a video that I would want to share with my audience, the world. Recently, it's still ongoing, the arts exhibition that is taking place at the Embassy of Colombia, and it is open to the public. We were there, and then we met with, I think, three of the artists, and we engaged them. So if my producer is listening and is ready with the video, let's take a look at the video. And we will come back to the studio.
This is a picture of Kwame Nkrumah, the first president of Ghana. And I use a waste material, the fabric, to do this work. It wasn't easy at the first, but you know, consistency made me develop this?
Well, art came to me after a health issue. So 2 years ago, I had a recovery period for at least 1 year. And during this period, one of my doctors used to say that in life, when you don't do anything, you are in a recovery period, you cannot go to work, you cannot be active. Either you read, either you write, either you use your creativity to paint and to create. So I decided to draw, to paint, and art came to me just during this period of my life. So I used to say that I discovered myself during a recovery period. I met Madame Claudia only a few years ago, and then so the ambassador gave me a very good opportunity to do my first exhibition here in Ghana. It's my first exhibition, so it's a very big challenge for me. And then the ambassador really supports me, and yeah, so that's my relation with Colombia. I would just like to thank her for this opportunity, having my first exhibition with two other artists here in Ghana at the Colombian Embassy. So yeah, it's a big support, and I'm very, how can I say, glad, and I'm very glad.
To be an artist in Ghana is very, very difficult. Yeah. So this is what we want the government to do. We want the government to help the young artists so that we can do something in our country, so that people will appreciate our artworks. I was having an exhibition, and Ambassador Claudia came in there to, you know, see my painting. The thing was like, wow, Kelvin, I love your paintings. So she bought some of my paintings, and that's when we started friendship. Yes, I just want to say thank you so much, Ambassador Claudia or Colombia Embassy, for this opportunity.
So that was an art exhibition organized at the Colombian Embassy, and the Colombian ambassador is here to tell us more about it. Tell us about this particular initiative.
Well,
how did it happen? Empowering three young men.
You said something interesting, and it is my love for culture, and this is truth. And since I arrived, I have had many meetings, many opportunities to put together artists, writers, storytellers, painters, singers. So it is something that is part of my life in Ghana. And these three young, these three people I have met through my time here, mm-hmm. and I found, in reality, I saw the Steven, that is the one of the particular different painting, and I invited him, and I said, I want to invite you because I think that you have talent, because I wanted to support him. And then I said, no, but I don't want to do it for him alone. I really want to do for other person that I know, and then that I saw that the art would somehow be had something in common. And so I have a personal relation with each one of them, and all of them need support.
And so, you offered that support.
So, yes. And I said, for me, it is not, it's the Colombian embassy, there is no Colombian there, but I believe that it also shows link, right. And it shows the integration that we have. So if I have the opportunity, I'll do it. And it has been so beautiful, and I have found that doing something without any pretension, it was really supporting.
Yeah.
So invite the people and invite you. And I found that people, beautiful people like you, supported too.
Yes, I saw the amazing people, the caliber of people that patronized or is still patronizing this art exhibition. And I must say that you have done very well because I'm on the ground. So I often see what happens on the ground, who is doing what. And for me, when I spoke to them or engaged them, it showed strength, power. They've been given something to be better. I mean, the arts industry is still being worked on, or they are still working. We have the industry players are still working on the arts industry. And so just to make it better, attractive, so it can, you know, earn the income that it needs to. So they are working on that. And so when you did this, I found that to be very, very touching, that you gave them the power to also begin to know that they are doing something great and they are contributing to, you know, society.
For Stephen, it's the first exhibition of his life.
That was his first time.
Yes.
His first experience.
Yes. And so, that was, and you see that the wonderful thing.
Right. Well, that's beautiful.
And, for Kelvin, no, and for Philip. Mm. No, but Philip is fantastic too, and Kelvin, it's all good. I just want to tell you that I have the Writer's Cafe in my house.
The Writer's Cafe?
Yes. And I work with a professor with Atukwe and the friend Appenteng. Appenteng from the. So, with the three of us got together, and during every month, the Monday of the month, we invited writers and people to get together. It was an open house in my house. This time I made it, but it was in my house. And so we had always wonderful people. And at the end, I was receiving the interest or the expression, not only of Ghanaians. I had people from Nigeria, everybody,
in the
friends.
Diaspora.
So we had
it. You're doing a lot.
And I miss it.
All right. It's been great. You said something when we started the conversation. You said that Colombia is not one of the countries that is financially sound, that has a financial ability to bring investors and to contribute to Ghana's growth. Not to partner in that area with Ghana. But what it can give to Ghana is to use one of the best approaches to diplomacy, which is cultural diplomacy, to get the people together. And so this is diplomacy from the roots to the top. You're engaging the people on the ground. So you engage the ordinary people and you create initiatives and see how best you can fuse it or get them together to work in that area. And for me, I think that is the work of a true diplomat. Even when the money comes, you still need to decide where it goes, and you need to be part of everything, every penny spent on the ground. And when I find myself in your midst, I'm just happy, and I watch with so much admiration. So I'm happy that you are here doing this. I have just a couple of messages. I'll take them, and then we will wrap up.
Okay.
I know you are tired. You need to rest. So Kojo Dankwa says, I am watching live from abroad, DR Congo, to be precise. Well, thank you very much. Remember, the program is streaming on Facebook and on YouTube. So even after the show, you can still leave your comments and then we will read them right here. If we need to follow up, I know where to direct you to. If you need to meet Claudia or you want to be part of the art exhibition that is currently ongoing at the embassy, it is open to the public, right?
Absolutely, yes.
So anyone at all can just walk into the Embassy of Colombia and then have an experience with art, you know, experience at the various types of art, and then just to know the importance, the significance of art in our lives. All right, thank you very much, Kojo Dankwa. And this one says, Mochicha J, what a name. She says, I love your outfit, Harriet. Well, thank you very much. And she says, your guest is looking so beautiful. Oh, Claudia,
yeah,
you are looking beautiful. And
we
are looking beautiful, right? We are looking beautiful. And Sarah Appenting said, okay, so Sarah was trying to help me understand what she meant when you said cacao. Yeah, it was like cocoa, you know. Well, thank you very much. I got that one. Final words, Claudia.
Thanks for your generosity. Thanks for the wishing to share with your audience this experience. And I valorate it. Thank you so much. And I am ready to continue working for your beautiful country and for my beautiful country, strengthening our relationship in many different areas and business also. Business is another thing that
there's a lot happening, right?
Yes. And investment. I think that I have a very important Colombian company next year to invest. I am trying.
Okay.
And so that's another effort. Thank you. All and right. Congratulations for your wonderful program.
Oh.
I really am happy to be here. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Claudia. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for coming on the show. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you very much for sending us your messages. And thank you very much for making time to be with us every Saturday at 4 o'clock when we come your way with Diplomatic Affairs. And so we are grateful for your time. And we look forward to seeing you same time next week. Don't forget to pass by the Colombian Embassy if you want to see what is happening. The art exhibition is open to the public, so you can just pass by and have an experience with art. It's a wonderful experience. Thank you very much, Claudia, for coming. And thank you very much for watching. Enjoy the rest of our programs. Bye-bye.
Even if it makes me blind, I just wanna see the light. Breathe in.